The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Yes, I lift you high.
She's over. waking up to a new sunrise, looking back from the other side. I can see now with open eyes, darkest water and deepest pain. I wouldn't trade it for anything, 'cause my brokenness brought me to you, and these wounds are a story we'll use. So I'm thankful for the scars, 'cause without them
Oh, If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice, tell the same old lies, if you're trying to feel the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fire. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. And there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker.
Mic test. Testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing. All right. Oh, this mic is live. Well, I'm here to tell you the good news. So the good news is, do you remember during COVID we couldn't be packed into a room like this? Right? So we all just start from a place of complete gratitude and thanksgiving that we can breathe on one another. In fact, why don't you just kind of elbow or give a hug to somebody? You don't have to breathe on them. But say Merry Christmas and please welcome your neighbor. So the potential bad news is that we're really full, and the lobby will stream everything you're going to see here, everything that's going to be online, live. The lobby will stream it. So if you can't stand and we don't have a seat for you, we are setting seats up in the lobby. It's a little cooler in the lobby, and it's only going to get warmer in here after all the hot air. It shared. And you're closer to the cookies in the bake sale from the lobby. Just trying to look at the highlights. We will start in just a moment. If you have a free seat, if you're sure that someone's not stuck on the 78 coming and they're just not going to be here and that seat isn't going to be taken, we could scoot to the middle, or just we can wave. How many seats do we have open that are free? Just one over here, a couple over here, a couple in here. So there are seats. You see where the hands are up? That's awesome. Anybody staying in the back, if you want to take a glance at hands that are up, there's some here, some over there still. All right.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening. Welcome to Calvin Christian School's annual Christmas concert. My name is David Illman. For those who don't know, I'm the upper school principal overseeing the junior high and high school, and I have the honor and privilege to welcome you with announcements and also the opening prayer, and then we will begin. We ask you to please silence your phones. And also, no flash photography. There will be a recording posted on our YouTube channel for later viewing, if you'd like to do so. There is also no intermission, so if you must leave to use the restroom or for any reason to go out into the lobby, please do so in between the songs. We also invite you to the plaza after the concert for Hot Cocoa and the Music Boosters annual bake sale. I don't know if you saw it as you were coming in. To me, it looks like a European Christmas market. And new this year, we have fresh handmade wreaths for sale. And all these funds will go directly to support the Calvin Christian Music Program. So without further ado, let me pray. Lord in heaven, we thank you for this glorious evening. It's glorious because you are here with us now. And we invite you, Holy Spirit, to be present. as you listen to what you enjoy most, and that's hearing the glorious, beautiful voices of children singing to your glory. And Lord, we thank you for that invitation, that privilege to do so, to glorify your name and your kingdom. And Lord, we thank you so much for this annual reminder that you did not come down in pomp and circumstance, but you came down in fragility as one of us, Emmanuel, as a helpless babe. Lord, help us to be reminded of that this evening and for this Christmas season. And King Jesus, we love you and we
the world. He made Adam and Eve and put them in the beautiful Garden of Eden. Then one day, the devil disguised as a snake came in and tempted them to eat a fruit from a tree that God had told them not to touch. After they ate the forbidden fruit, Adam and Eve were forced to leave the paradise that God had created for them because of their disobedience. But before they left, God made them a promise. The evil serpent would always be at war with even her children, and one day, Adam and Eve's descendants would defeat him forever. He is called the Messiah.
Years later, God made another promise. When he called Abraham to leave his home and go to a new country, God promised to bless him and make him the father of a great nation. His descendants would be as numerous as the stars of heaven and the sand on the seashore. Through him, all nations would be blessed.
Thank you. This is what God told the prophet Isaiah. The people who walk in darkness will see great light, for to us a child is born, to us a son is given. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Would you please join us in singing Come Thou Long Expected Jesus?
There shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse. A branch from his root shall bear fruit. Isaiah 11:1. God never forgets his promises. Even after hundreds of years, he promised Israel Messiah, a son of King David.
Thank you. One day, God sent an angel named Gabriel to a girl whose name was Mary. She was engaged to Joseph, a descendant of David. And the angel told her something she would never have expected to hear. God was giving her a gift, a baby boy who would be the Holy Son of God. He was to reign on David's throne forever in an everlasting kingdom, and his name was to be called Jesus.
The day finally came, the birth of the Son of God. It happened in a manger in a little town of Bethlehem. This was the Savior that Israel had been waiting for since Adam and Eve left the Garden of Eden. The screaming, crying baby who would one day die and come back to life, triumphantly beating the serpent forever. This was Jesus.
Please join us for the singing of Lo, How I Rose, Air Blooming.
And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us."
Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born the king of Jews? For we saw his star when it rose, and have come to worship him." And behold, the star that they had seen when it rose went before them, until it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
See the star up in heaven. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not nothing made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. He came to his own, and his own people.
Let every heart repent and prove.
Test, test. How do you feel about your kids? Doesn't that feel so good? You can be seated for a second unless someone's already taken your seat. I'm sorry about that. We want to give some big thanks up here on stage, and you saw the motioning all the way over to my far left over there in the green dresses, Mrs. Maggie Fisk accompanying tonight. We have some students bringing out some gifts, and then to her left there is Mrs. Jessica Faber. She's our elementary music teacher. And then all the way over here on stage left is Mr. Daniel Seaman, our upper school music teacher. And now I just want to say to all of you young, beautiful, aren't they beautiful? They beautiful, young image bearers. I want you to listen to me because I'm speaking for your parents right now. I want to say thank you. Thank you for listening to your teachers, for learning all of this music, for listening to the melodies and all the words that you learned in a different language, all the hand motions. Some of you had solos, the readings. I want to thank you, and I want to tell you why I'm thanking you. Listen, because it was a big blessing to us, and I want to prove it to you. I'm going to ask a question to those people out there and see if they agree with me. Was it a big blessing to you, all this work? Yes, it was. Amen. You guys can sit down real quick right up here, just like we did on the earlier show. If you guys want to take a quick seat, right on down. There you go. We have a couple quick announcements. We're going to pray to go, and then we will make our way outside. My name is Jeff Pratt. I serve as one of the administrators here at Calvin Christian School, my sixth year. What a privilege it is for me to do that. I have a couple of quick things to say. First of all, if you could think about digging deep, maybe inside your pocket, especially if you felt that blessing tonight, it is a tradition. We used to pass buckets around, which we thought maybe wasn't maybe the better idea, but we're hoping that it's a great idea that you find green stuff with lots of digits on it. And there's two boxes. They're beautifully decorated. And if you can make, it's a free will offering that goes directly to our music department. Very, very important. We're very, very grateful that you do that and join us. And if you want to talk about, you know, with the year end coming up, if you want to talk about more zeros or writing other checks, we're available to do that right outside as well as we're getting to the end of our fall drive. We have a wonderful bake sale out there, and I'm told, but we're not going to do this right now, and you're all going to be so tempted when I tell you what I'm about to say. Apparently, there is, and Mrs. Monica, you're coming down here? Are you here? Okay. There is hidden under one of the seats. Don't look now, because you can't, all right? It won't be possible. But if you find that under your seat or the back edge, if you find there's a special little note there, here's what's going to happen.
Okay, so yeah, if you are the lucky winner, we wanted to give away one of our box of cookies. So I don't know if you saw our bake sale that's set up out right in front of the team room out on the plaza. Thank you, by the way, if you were one of the people who donated. So everything out there was all donated to the Music Boosters, which our job is just to raise money for the music department. And it's so amazing. I'm so thankful to be at a school that values music as a gift of God and just is committed to instilling a love for music in our children. So we're out there. We have tons of yummy baked goods. Everything was handmade. So please come. We're going to sell out. And if you've noticed some of the wreaths, Sarah Ellers made some incredible handmade wreaths out there. Those are for sale as well. We only have a few left. So get out there and grab one. My name is Monica, and I have some kids. We have two kids here in the elementary, and we love it. We've been here almost 2 years, and we're very, very grateful to be here. And I got wrangled into being the Music Boosters president.
So, thank you. Thank you very much, Monica. Yes, you can. We're going to take it out there. Yeah, so if you find that paper, you take it out and see one of the ladies. Literally, when you walk out there, it's going to be like stepping into a Hallmark movie when you see this bake sale. And we want every last goodie to disappear, and you can begin eating whenever you want. Okay? The goodies are there. There's hot chocolate. Wonderful time. It's my privilege to close us in prayer. And what I'd like to do is I'd love to share a prayer with you. Similar to how we closed the band concert. Mr. Illman, our upper school principal, closed our band concert by reading a prayer from John Calvin, the great 16th century theologian who our school is named after. But I'd like to read this prayer tonight based on Luke 2, verses 13 to 14. And it was only written 9 years ago and is written by a gentleman named Scotty Smith, who's like a pastor to pastors. He's the mentor of my pastor, Pastor Paul Kim at Redeemer Presbyterian. And I'd love to share this with you and have this be our Advent prayer. So here's the passage, and then we'll pray, and we're going to sing the doxology, and that's how we're going to close it off. Here's the passage. Suddenly a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." Will you pray with me? Dear Heavenly Father, there is no way to calculate the riches of this declaration. It's more than we could ever hope or imagine, yet that for which we deeply long, you are at peace with us. We are your beloved children, upon whom your full and permanent favor rests. All of this is true because the gospel is true. Father, if unredeemed angels were in such awe of such good news, how much more should we be staggered and astonished, humbled and grateful, liberated and transformed? By your Holy Spirit, inflame our hearts, stir our affections, and restore to us the joy of so great a salvation. We invest much of our lives seeking favor, wanting to be wanted and longing to be celebrated and seeking to be acceptable. We look to spouses and kids, education and exercise, vocations and vacations, even to spiritual disciplines and ministry to give us what you alone give us so freely and so fully in Jesus. And what a paradox, Father. The more we come alive to the riches of the gospel, the less we obsess about our own lives. We won't end up thinking more of ourselves or less of ourselves. We just think of ourselves less often. How liberating. Lord Jesus, may this old host of angels drive us into new worship of you this Advent season. Oh, come, let us adore you indeed, for you have lived and died in our place. Now raised for our justification, you will return for our glorification. Hallelujah. What a savior. Hallelujah. What a salvation. So very amen, we pray in your holy and loving name. And together we say, amen.
They saved the best for last, apparently. My name is Paul Lapka. I serve in the elementary principal role. Mr. Illman and Dr. J said we should wear sport coats tonight. So I busted out my best one that I could wear for you. We're going to let you sit for just a little while longer. We want to get the elementary students back to the gym. So if you are a parent of an elementary student, at least one of you needs to come pick up your child or children while the other one's shopping for baked goods. But please come and get them. We don't want them running around in the gym for an hour after all of this. So I'm going to dismiss the elementary students. The junior high and high schooler students get to hang out here for a moment. Once all the elementary is gone, then you can all start your exits. Thank you for joining us.
My God, how great thou art. for what you're calling me to. Alone with your strength, I got no excuse. 'Cause broken people are exactly who you use. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, more deep than the fails. So I can face my giants with confidence. You took a shepherd boy and made him a king. So I'm gonna trust you and gave you everything. I'll be a conqueror, 'cause you fight for me. I'll be a champion, claiming your victory. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, more deep than the fails. So I can face my giants with confidence. I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the wall. Won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, Jesus. I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the wall.
Oh, Thank you. Thank you. Jazz.